On the night of October 24th of 2003, my husband and my brother had gone out for a quick bite to eat. My husband was a passenger and my brother was the driver, and they were on their way home. My brother was stopped at a red light. When the arrow turned green, he proceeded through the intersection, and that's when a motorist ran the light. I got a phone call that urged me to come to our intersection, which is only a mile and a quarter from our home. And I was 9 months pregnant and I ran, and I just saw lights and sirens, and the whole world stopped for me at that moment. He had died on impact, so he had lost his life right there. And it's a brutal scene that nobody ever wants to see. It doesn't ever go away. I promised my husband that night, even though he had already passed, that I would take care of our unborn child and that I would make sure that she was a happy baby and that she would be born into love and that she would be born into goodness and she would not be marked by tragedy.
She'd leave for the park for the dog time to
play.
And because of that promise, because of the love that I've shared with my husband, and because of the love that I have for my daughter, I've been able to go on to campaign for red light cameras at the intersections in the state of Florida. I studied the cameras and how they worked and why they worked, and looked at other states and really got into detail as how they can curb the behaviors of red light running. And I realized that that was going to be a deterrent. That was a way to make sure that somebody else wouldn't have to die so tragically at an intersection. My daughter is a mirror image of my husband. She possesses all of his most amazing traits, down to her little toes. She is my husband, except for the color of her eyes. And she exemplifies who he was in this lifetime. From the moment she was born, you know, I held her in my arms and I told her about her dad. And I told her that physically he's not with us, but spiritually that he is. And it's a way for her to know the beautiful man that her father was. You know, because he didn't deserve to die that night at that intersection. So for us together as a team, I feel that we'll continue to go on for a long time and put safety back on our highways. And that's what intersection safety cameras do. They put safety back on our highways.